The project window is where we can easily locate and manage all of the assets in our project. The project window is a direct mirror of the assets folder on our hard drive. The project window allows us to easily access the items in our assets folder while working within the Unity editor. Assets in the project window are listed in hierarchical order. We can use the drop-down button beside each folder to expand or collapse the folder and view any files or nested folders it contains. Along the top of the project window is the toolbar. At the top left of the toolbar, we can see the Create button. The Create button is a mirror menu of the Assets, Create drop-down menu found in the menu bar. The Create menu allows us to create new assets for our game, including new folders for our project, new scripts for coding our game with, new materials for use on our models, or even a new empty scene. Any new asset that we create in the Create menu will be stored inside of the Assets folder on our hard drive and will be visible in the project window, ready to be used in our game. Assets created outside of Unity can be imported into the project window. To import an asset into our project, we can choose Asset, Import New Asset, or right-click in the project window and choose Import New Asset. This will open up a File Explorer window and allow us to navigate to a desired location and select the asset we wish to import from our computer. An alternative way to import assets into our project is to save or copy a file to our Assets folder directly from the Finder or Explorer. When we save or copy a file to our Assets folder, it will also be imported and become visible in the project window. It is also possible to simply drag the new asset and drop it into the project window itself. In most cases, the items in our project window represent files on our computer, so it's worth noting that if we delete them in the project window, we are deleting them from our computer too. If we want to import collections of assets into our project, we can use asset packages. For more on asset packages, see the information linked below. If we look in our assets folder, we can see a meta file associated with each of our assets. Meta files are files created by Unity when a new asset is created or imported. Meta files contain important information about how the asset is used in the project. It is important that these meta files stay with the asset they relate to. If we wish to relocate or restructure items in our asset folder, it is recommended to do so from within Unity using the project window, as Unity will automatically move or rename the corresponding meta file. So it's worth noting that we can add new files directly to our asset folder from outside of Unity, but moving, changing, renaming, or deleting assets should be done from within the Unity project window. Once we've created and imported our assets, it's easy to add them to our game from the project window. After selecting an asset that we would like to use in our scene, such as a 3D mesh or game object prefab, we can simply drag the asset from the project window and drop it into the scene view or hierarchy view, and the asset is now usable in our scene. Similarly, with other items such as scripts, textures, or materials, we can drag and drop them from the project window into inspector fields, hierarchy items, or directly onto objects in the scene view to add them to our game. The project window has two main layout modes that we can switch between to help us better view and navigate all of the assets in our project. To change the view type of the project window, we can select the drop-down in the top right and choose between a one or two column layout. In the two column layout, the first column on the left lists all of the folders in our project. Note that in this layout mode, the list will only display nested folders. We can browse the contents of any folder by clicking on its name in the list. The second column on the right shows us the contents of the selected folder. In this view, assets are shown as icons that indicate their type. This view helps us to quickly and visually identify our scripts, materials, textures, prefabs, subfolders, and other assets. At the top of the second column is the breadcrumb trail. The breadcrumb trail shows us the path to the folder that we are currently viewing. At the bottom of the second column, we can see our currently selected asset. The adjacent slider allows us to change the size of the thumbnail icons in the project window to better locate any asset that we are looking for. We can also look into any hierarchies of prefabs by clicking the right arrow to expand or collapse them. The final part of the project window, in the top right of the toolbar, is the search bar and filter buttons. The search bar allows us to easily locate assets by name, label, or type. This is especially useful for locating assets if we're working with large or unfamiliar projects. When we type into the search bar, the project window will return any item in the asset folder that matches our search string. The three buttons next to the search bar allow us to filter our search results by type or label, or save our search results. The first button will allow us to filter our search results by common types available in Unity projects. The next button allows us to filter our search results by label. Labels can be set for an asset in the inspector. It's worth noting that, since labels can be custom defined, the number of labels has potential to be very large, so the label menu has its own mini search filter box to easily find our custom labels. Alternatively, if we wish to filter by type or label while searching, we can type the filter into the search bar ourselves. The third button in the project window allows us to save our search result to the Favorites section. Favorites are a list of assets that we can define in order to give us easy access to them later. These are often frequently used assets such as scripts, models, materials, or prefabs. Favorites are stored at the top of the project browser hierarchy when using the two-column layout. We can save searches as a favorite group using the Save Search button and choosing a name for our search group. We can then return to this search at any time by selecting the group from the Favorites menu. We can also drag any folder from the hierarchy list into the Favorites menu to save it as a favorite folder. Finally, we can also search for any items on the Asset Store by simply typing into the search field and switching from Asset to Asset Store. If we select an item from the list, its details will be displayed in the inspector, along with the option to purchase and or download it. As we can see, the project window makes it simple and fast to manage assets in our project.